You're watching the Physics Classroom's video tutorial on vectors and projectiles. The topic of this video is graphical method of vector addition. And here's the one question we wish to answer. How can a scale diagram be used to graphically add two or more vectors? Let's get started. Whenever we graphically add vectors, we utilize the head-to-tail method of vector addition. That is, if we have to add vectors B, G, and V, we begin by first drawing vector B. And then we add G to it, placing the tail of vector G at the arrowhead of vector B. Once G is drawn, we can then draw vector V, placing its tail at the arrowhead of vector G. Once all the vectors have been drawn, we can draw the resultant vector, the answer to the question, what is B plus G plus V? That resultant vector is drawn from the tail of the first vector to the arrowhead of the last vector. That's how we graphically add vectors in a head-to-tail fashion. In this video, we'll learn how to use a scaled vector addition diagram in order to graphically add two or more vectors. Such as here, we want to add vectors A plus B plus C. Their magnitude and direction is given. Our first step is we have to choose a scale. A scale tells us the ratio of the distance on paper to the real-life magnitude of a vector. Here, when we're adding these three vectors, we'll start with the scale 1 centimeter on the sheet of paper is equal to 0.5 kilometers of the vector. We'll begin with vector A. I'm going to choose a starting point way off to the right, and then I'm going to draw a 10 centimeter vector westward. This represents a 5 kilometer vector directed westward. That's vector A. Where the arrowhead of A ends, I'm going to begin B, starting its tail right there at the end of vector A. I'm going to draw a vector 5 centimeters upward. That represents vector B. Where vector B ends, I'm now going to draw vector C, starting it there at the arrowhead of vector B. I'm going to draw this vector 7 centimeters in length, and I'm going to direct it 15 degrees south of east. That would be equivalent to 345 degrees counterclockwise from east. Once all three vectors are drawn, I'll draw the resulting vector starting at the tail of A and heading to the arrowhead of C. This resultant vector can then be measured. Its length, once measured, is 4.6 centimeters, and I can use the scale to convert that to a real-life magnitude of the resultant. Then, using a protractor, I can find the direction of this vector. It's approximately 135 degrees counterclockwise from east. That's how we graphically add vectors A plus B plus C. Here we will summarize the procedure for the graphical method of vector addition. First, decide on an appropriate scale, one that makes the vector fill approximately all the space that's provided for the problem. Record the scale on the diagram. Then pick a starting point such that you don't extend your vector off any sides of the allotted space. Third, draw the first vector with the appropriate length and in the indicated direction. Once done, draw the second and remaining vectors with the appropriate length and direction, and always begin each vector at the arrowhead of the previous vector. Fifth, draw the resultant from the tail of the first vector to the arrowhead of the last vector. Then, to determine its magnitude and direction, measure the length of the resultant and use the scale to convert to magnitude. Then use a protractor, placing the origin of that protractor at the tail of the first vector. Measure the resultant's direction. Use the accepted convention, whatever it happens to be for your course. We will frequently use the counterclockwise from east convention. Now I will apply these 7 steps to the addition of vectors A plus B plus C in the allotted space. I will begin by picking a scale of 1 centimeter on the sheet of paper is equal to 1 kilometer magnitude. Then I choose a starting point, and I like to add crosshairs to the starting point. Now I will measure out vector A from this starting point. I will begin by measuring its direction 150 degrees counterclockwise from east. I put a hash mark down to indicate the reference point for this vector, and then measure out an 8 centimeter vector through this hash mark. I put an arrowhead on vector A and label its magnitude and direction. Vector B will start from the arrowhead of A. Vector B's direction is 220 degrees, which is 40 degrees south of west. Using a protractor, I place a reference point on the paper, and I will aim vector B through this reference point, extending it 6 centimeters from the arrowhead of A. I put an arrowhead on vector B and I label its magnitude and direction. Vector C will begin from the arrowhead of B. Vector C is 290 degrees, that's 20 degrees, east of south. Using a protractor, I mark a reference point, and then I will aim vector C towards the reference point 5 centimeters from the arrowhead of B. I put an arrowhead on vector C and label its magnitude and direction. Now I will draw the resultant, beginning from the tail of vector A and extending to the arrowhead of vector C. I put an arrowhead on the resultant and I label it R for resultant. I now use a ruler to measure the magnitude of the resultant to be approximately 10.8 centimeters, and I convert that to scale. I then use a protractor to measure the direction of this vector counterclockwise from east. It's 25 degrees south of east. That makes it 205 degrees counterclockwise from east. I label this on the diagram. Done. Now we're going to discuss several common pitfalls that happen when you use the graphical method of vector addition. The first one is the choice of an inappropriate scale. Like here, we have all this allotted space, but the scale is chosen such that the vector addition diagram doesn't really fill the space. It takes up just a little bit of the allotted space. Anytime you're doing a vector addition diagram, you're going to make a 1 millimeter error or thereabouts. But with this type of scale, a 1 millimeter error corresponds to a 1 kilometer error in the magnitude of a vector. For vector A, that would be about a 10% error. That's unacceptable. So what you'd really want to do is choose a bigger scale. But don't choose a scale so big that after you draw vector A and you begin to draw vector B, it actually goes outside of the allotted space. So these are all errors having to do with scale. The next set of errors have to do in one way or another with the resultant. The first thing you could do is maybe not draw the resultant after you've added the vectors. Or maybe you do draw the resultant, but you don't report the magnitude and direction of the resultant. The resultant's the answer. You surely have to come up with a resultant, an answer, and a magnitude and direction for it. And then finally, you could draw the resultant, and you could find its magnitude and direction, but you drew the wrong resultant, or you measured the wrong direction or magnitude. Here's some examples. Here we're adding A and B, and at once done, we haven't shown the resultant. Okay, that's a pitfall. That's a problem. You have to draw the resultant. This is a little bit better. You've drawn A and B. You've drawn the resultant, but you haven't measured its magnitude and direction, a very common problem. Here's a third situation where you've drawn A, you drawn B, and you drew the result, and you even came up with a magnitude and direction. The problem is that when you found the direction, you measured it up at the arrowhead of the resultant instead of down at the tail of the resultant. These are all problems having to do with resultant issues. The fifth common pitfall is not adding the vectors head to tail. Like here in this example, vector A is drawn, but then vector B is drawn starting at the tail of the first vector, and the resultant's drawn from one vector to another vector instead of from the beginning to the end. This is a problem. Here's another problem, not actually labeling the vectors or the resultant. For instance, in this diagram, you can't tell what is what. Vector A is drawn horizontally, and vector B is added to it at the in a head-to-tail fashion, but since nothing's labeled, you don't really know which vector is which vector. The seventh and final pitfall of the graphical method of vector addition involves selecting a bad starting point. Like here, we have to add a west vector A and then a northwest vector B. And we start right here, and the result is by the time we start drawing vector B, we've gone off the page of the paper before we ever finish it. Instead of starting way over in the bottom right, which would have easily fit both vector A and vector B on the page of paper, we started in the wrong spot. The famous physicist and philosopher Will Rogers once said that good judgment comes from experience. And unfortunately, a whole lot of that comes from bad judgment. The point here being that in order to understand how to do the graphical method of vector addition, you have to practice, practice, practice. Speaking of practice, it's time for me to give you an action plan, a series of next steps for making this learning stick. But before I help you out with an action plan, maybe you could help us out. If you enjoyed the video, maybe you can hit the like button or even subscribe to the channel. And we'd finally love to hear from you in the comments section down below. Now for the action plan. I'm going to mention 5 resources at our website, physicsclassroom.com, and links to each one of these resources is down in the description section for this video. I recommend picking one or two of them and giving them a try. The first one's from our physics help section, and what it is 12 different vector addition practice problems where you graphically add vectors, and then you can check your answer with an answer key. Second, we have a concept builder known as head-to-tail vector addition. Awesome practice and awesome review for this video. The third suggestion is more of a playful activity that you can do. It's a physics interactive simulation on our website called vector addition. You can drag a vector onto the workspace and change the size and add vectors together and view the resultant. For a more rigorous workout, try Minds on Physics. You can get the app for your phone or Macintosh computer or tablet and then download app number one. Go to the Vectors and Projectiles module and try missions VP2 and VP3. Finally, we have a tutorial on our website, and it's a great place to freshen up on the topic. You can quickly get to whatever you need to get to. We recommend our page titled Vector Addition. Whatever you do, we wish you the best of luck.